Are you saying that tacky is not practiced by a Muslim? Right here in this park, every week.
You are the one that's saying Allah is not the name of God. Enough. Or God is not Allah. Yeah. So I then said, hold on a second, what came to my mind was not something to try and put you down, but I was thinking, then what do the Arab Christians
right, that's fine.
Call God?
No, and your question is fine.
And then you clearly said they call him Allah, so then you're contradicting yourself.
Right, the point is...
I feel like you're just really confusing
the No, you're confusing the issue because my subject
But you said Allah is not the name of God.
No,
so why do these Arab Christians call him Allah?
I just
that
said,
is a simple
because
simple
the Quran
question,
is translated in Arabic and it's political.
What's the politics? What, someone's going to shoot them if they don't call him Allah?
So how do you think...
Why don't you call him by his real name?
My friend, you're playing games. God can forgive sins. These are plain basics.
Only God can forgive sins.
Yeah, would you agree that only God can forgive sins?
I agree with that.
Right. Jesus said that I can forgive sins.
So was he God?
There, hold on.
Was he God?
By that claim, he's
was
saying...
Was Jesus God?
I'm answering my question. By that claim, yes, he's saying he's God. By that very claim. If God is the only... There's certain attributes you would agree.
So are you saying he's made his own mother pregnant?
I think that's filming or something.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I think that's filming.
I think you're rocking it away.
Well, good.
Am I going to be a star on YouTube?
Yeah.
Allah hasn't got a mouth.
Excuse me.
Allah hasn't got a mouth. No. You're wrong. The word is taken. Allah hasn't got a mouth. Allah hasn't got a mouth. So nothing comes out of from his mouth. He hasn't got a mouth.
Not where I was. It's where they're trying to drag me out of desperation. So let's go back to where I was. The Quran said that the Jews boasted that they killed the Messiah, but they killed him not, neither did they crucify him. So my question, there's a million and one problems in that one verse. My first question is, when did the Jews make this boast that they killed the Messiah? Do you know what that's actually saying? The Jews were waiting for a Messiah, their savior, their hero, and they killed him and boasted about it? You killed your hero and boasted about it.
But the Jews didn't
so my question
him.
Is,
the Jews are, from what I know,
but you're happy with that, right? You're happy
the
that they killed Jesus, right?
To be the Messiah.
That's no, otherwise you wouldn't be saved.
Right. So my point is,
still wrong. But you're happy that the Jews killed
what
Jesus.
What I'm saying is, my question is this. This is my question.
It's not complicated. No, no, sorry. Let's
say happy that Jesus died.
There were Jews that actually wanted to be the Messiah.
I am glad that Jesus died.
Your salvation came from criminal. Now let's deal with those ones. Let's deal with the ones because what the Quran got wrong is if it said if they didn't. Said that we killed Jesus because we didn't think he was the Messiah, that would make sense. But to say we killed the Messiah is saying we killed our hero.
That's all I
believe. The reason why that's not clear to Muslims because they don't know what Messiah means. No, sorry. You have to understand what Messiah means. Messiah means someone that saves the nation, that saves the people. If they wouldn't have said we killed the Messiah, they would have said we killed Jesus. Because he wasn't the Messiah. So my point is, why did the Quran say, it's two things, why did the Quran say that,
spirit,
and also when did this take place? At what point in history, can you show me some evidence, some document where Jews are known to have boasted that they killed the Messiah, the person that are waiting to come and save their nation?
I am acknowledging it.
The Quran made a claim, and you believe that claim, don't you? Do you believe it?
I haven't heard anything otherwise.
Surah 457. Okay, but do you believe Surah 457?
You seem to know more about it than me, so
I'm glad that Jesus died.
Right, okay, well, because what I'm saying is our eternity.
I'm not here to try
that.
And.
No, that's fine.
It seems like that's what you seem to be.
No, I'm not trying to believe that. I'm asking a question, and this is why. Let me get to the point. Because your eternity and my eternity hangs on that. Either Jesus died or he didn't die. It can't be both. So the Bible, hold on. The Bible said that Jesus died. And the Roman crucifixion. History testifies to this as well. You can put the Bible aside, and you can put the Quran aside, and history will tell you that a man called Jesus died. Doesn't matter what the ramifications are, whether that ends in being dying for the sins of the world is irrelevant. We know historically that a man called Jesus died under Roman crucifixion.
According to
history. According to the Babylonian Talmud, according to first century. Hold on, let me give you some sources. According to Babylonian Talmud, according to legal and historical documents in the Sanhedrin Council. You know the Sanhedrin Council? Right, they had documents. Legal court documents and historical documents that said that Jesus, historically speaking, not spiritually speaking, it said that this man called Jesus died in the Roman crucifixion for sedition. He was accused of sedition and basically trying to overthrow the government and work in witchcraft. So this is purely historical. It's not saying he was the Messiah, therefore. It's just saying that he was the Messiah. No, they're not coming to the conclusion that because he died, he was the Messiah or he died for the sins of the world. None of that either. these are not believers. Him. They're just simply saying that it's a historical man.
But he gave up.
So I'm saying you can put aside the Quran and you can put aside the Bible.
Gave up.
See that historical man called Jesus died. Putting aside the religious ramifications, died for sins in the world. Forget all that. But we know that human being died. So back to Surah 4157. Surah 4157 is denying an historical event. It's saying that Jesus didn't die historically. And I'm saying there's no support for the Quran outside of himself on that claim. Right. Are you aware of it? And I'm saying if that's not the case, your balance hangs on. Both of our eternity hang on it. Our salvation hangs on it. If Jesus didn't die, my faith is alive.
But if there was no Quran, there was no Bible, I still know that there's a creator.
Yes, I know that.
I believe in that creator.
Yeah, but that's not good enough. That's not good enough.
Why is that?
Right, because I'm saying, because according to the Bible, and the Quran, according to the Bible, Jesus died.
I don't follow that type of creator. I follow a creator that I can just look around. I don't need you. I don't need anybody to tell me that there is a creator, and I recognize that creator. And the purpose of my creation was to worship that creator. So regardless of whether Jesus was there, Muhammad wasn't there, I would have still come to the conclusion that there is that creator.
Yeah, but if we're just taking you to Allah,
it has been clarified to me in Islam that I must worship that creator.
Right, exactly.
As a Muslim, I already know that there's that creator.
Right, of course.
My teaching of Islam doesn't tell me to worship or prostrate or believe there was a man with these magical powers and fairy tales, etc., etc. I don't need to worry about that. Even Muhammad himself only claimed to be a man.
But your claim, your authority...
And likewise, all of the other messengers and the prophets that came before him actually claimed to be men. They didn't claim to be...
Apart from Jesus. Apart from Jesus. Jesus is the only one that claimed something more than being a man.
In what way did he claim
that? Look at the words of Jesus.
So who is he?
First of all, he claimed...
Who is he to you?
Hold on. Let's go through a list of stuff. Because we identify Jesus by what he says. Only God can forgive sins. These are plain basic stuff.
Only God can forgive sins.
Yeah, would you agree that only God can forgive sins?
I agree with that.
Right, Jesus said that I can forgive sins.
So was he God?
Hold on.
Was he God?
By that claim, he's
was
saying...
Was Jesus God?
I'm answering my question. By that claim, yes, he's saying he's God. By that very claim. If God is the only... There's certain attributes you would agree.
Are you saying he's made his own mother pregnant?
My friend, let's not degenerate.
Who was Jesus' mother? Because it's a logical question.
You're trying to avoid the subject. I'm dealing with historicity. And that's the problem that Islam has. I'm dealing with history.
No, I deal with logic. I deal with logic.
So you're not interested in facts and history and what's true and what's not true.
Facts according to who?
Right. Well, the Quran made it. I just told you. Facts according to the people that were there. Muhammad wasn't there when Jesus was alive. Now, you were saying that the disciples were lying. At least they claimed to be there. Even if you want to say they weren't there.
Was Paul there?
Hold on.
Was Paul there?
No, Paul wasn't there.
Did Paul ever see Jesus?
Yes, he did. But let's not get to that. Hold on, in a dream. Look, are we going to do this properly? Come on, let's do this properly.
Because I don't have that much knowledge about it, but I asked the questions which do not make sense.
Right, so all I'm simply... So let's leave it. That's fine. So let's leave it at this then. Your Quran made a claim that can't be substantiated, and I'm saying your eternity, both of our eternity.
What is his claim? Can we just clarify?
Right, both of our eternity, let's be clear, both yours and mine, our eternity and our salvation hangs on whether or not Jesus died or didn't die. And one book says he did die, and another one says he didn't. So one of us are wrong. They're not both true. Jesus didn't die and not die at the same time.
Which book says he died?
The Bible. Jesus died. And the Quran said that he didn't die because they said they didn't kill him. God took him up.
Okay.
So both statements can't be true. This is my point.
No, I agree.
Jesus, right. So
you understand logic there?
Yes. But that's also history.
One is clearly left and one is right.
Also, it's logic, yes, but it's also history.
I was very clear.
Either Jesus died or he didn't. So therefore, either your faith is wrong or mine is wrong. Mine is wrong if he didn't die and the Quran is correct that he was taken up. And yours is wrong if the Quran is wrong in saying that he was taken up and when in fact he died. So I'm saying our salvation hangs on it. This is why I keep using this verse. And everything else is nonsense outside of that. If Jesus didn't die, I'm wasting my time. Because that's what my faith is based on. That Jesus died when in fact, if it's true, I'll talk about it. Likewise with you. If in fact Jesus actually died, like he said he was going to, and he sacrificed, as opposed to him being taken up, you're wrong. So quite simply, you're wrong or I'm wrong. One of us are wrong. We're not both right. And that's why I use this verse only for that point. And I think that, and what we've got is we've got two books making a claim. You'll get nowhere. Two books are at loggerheads. There's got to be something in between that verifies one or the other. You can't just leave it at that and say maybe, or you can blind faith. And I'm saying that you look, you can put aside the Bible and you can put aside the Quran, and there's some evidence elsewhere. What does the evidence say? And I'm saying that the evidence says that a man, first of all, do you believe Jesus is historical? That he literally lived on earth as a man, walked on earth?
As a man?
Yeah.
Well, as a Muslim, I clearly do.
Right, okay, so.
I don't believe there's any Muslims that would disagree that Jesus was a prophet.
Right, sometimes I do wonder, the way Jesus is spoken about, Jesus, it sounds like a comic book character, I'll be honest.
Really?
Quran, yeah.
In what respect?
Just, for example, we know that in the culture, the Quran doesn't see Jesus in the culture in which he would have existed. For example, the Hebrews would not have thought that Jesus was an Israelite. They would not have called God Allah. The Hebrews did not call God Allah. That wasn't the name.
What did they call it?
It wasn't Allah.
What did they call it?
Jehovah or Yahweh.
That was Yahweh. The
name. Yeah, they didn't say Allah. Yeah, that, first of all, that name didn't exist. But the point I'm making, not to labor on the point.
I'm going to be honest, it's very difficult for me to really debate you because I don't really have that knowledge about
no,
the Bible.
No, that's fine. I'm not there to try and that's fine.
Put you down in any way. But I mean, for me, it's very logical that, you know, it makes very logical sense just to believe that God needs nobody. He doesn't need a mother, a father, a daughter, or a son. He's not in need of my sacrifice. He's not in need of a blood sacrifice. He doesn't need all of that. For me, I don't think God would really want to cause confusion. It's very simple for me to just accept that there is only one God. He's eternal, he's absolute, and there is nothing unto him. So for me, I don't see why God would even need to sacrifice his son. Because sacrifice means you forgo something, you feel the loss of something, you lose something. Now, does God ever feel the loss of anything?
What do you mean? Yes, actually.
He does.
Yes.
So,
for example, he feels the loss when his creation goes astray from him.
God
feels loss if his creation disobeys him or goes astray.
But what would be the purpose? What would be the purpose of? I mean, I would just some of the logical aspects of it. Some of the reasoning behind it. For example, if Jesus died, okay, could God recreate him?
God kind of didn't create him.
So what I'm saying is, I've landed from space, I'm a Martian, and I'm thinking to myself, you're saying he died for the sins, God died on the cross, okay? So what would be the purpose of it?
Right, the purpose of it is that from the Old Testament, it's all about prophecy.
But what would be the purpose behind it? Why would he have to die?
Well, first of all, God doesn't have to do anything.
Sorry?
To talk about have to.
Why did he though?
Right,
why did
okay,
he?
Right, why you did? Yeah. Right, okay, right, that's a good question. That's just a question of why he had to. You can get out to the bare bones and say that have to do nothing. Why he did? He chose to. He chose to choose a path of redemption for mankind. And it's not for me to really question why God does that.
Well, it is. I would question everything.
No, no, you can't.
I would question everything.
No, don't get me wrong.
I would even question, does God exist?
No, I don't mean in that sense. I mean in a sense, once you come to the world, you realize that God is mighty and God is sovereign,
right,
and what he does is best. I mean, in that sense. Not that you can't question it, but don't question it on a level as, I mean, don't question it on another level. Yes, because God said it was. That's what I'm saying.
So why didn't he? Why didn't he?
Let me answer that more. That's a good question. Because the very fact, this is what I'm saying. If God chose a path or a way, or this way as opposed to that way, by him doing that, it means that it's the best way.
Yeah, but my understanding of God is not.
But God, he does godly thing. He doesn't do like attributes like something like shedding blood or killing his son or suicide mission. He doesn't do that. That's not God.
Right, wait a minute.
That's Satan.
Wait a minute. No,
I believe that's Satan.
Hold on. Because let's get into the bones here. That's why I don't believe that your God and that is God.
Why?
Not my God.
Why is that?
Because the natures are very different. Extremely different.
Do you believe
God? I agree. The natures, I agree, because he doesn't come down as a man.
Yes.
He doesn't come down as a man.
So, that
theory of him coming down as a man, it sort of fits more and wonders amongst his creation.
Right, yes.
Fits more along the lines of what the pagans used to believe in.
Yeah.
As opposed to him just telling all... I mean, before Jesus, there were many other messengers and many other prophets. Okay? So why is it, after all the thousands of years, before... Jesus, did God have to just all of a sudden decide at that moment in time that he had to sack? Why couldn't he? Why? It sounds like he's a bit of an unfair God. The God that you believe in is quite unfair.
Can I answer that?
Because why didn't he just sacrifice his son in the beginning?
Okay, can I answer that? Right, can I answer that? Because God has a... First of all, it's wrong. It's incorrect to say that he was sovereign. God doesn't do something arbitrarily or knee-jerk
or illogically.
Or knee-jerk reaction. So first of all, you're wrong. Biblically speaking, it was always in God's plan. In the Old Testament, the previous scriptures, in other words, there were scriptures, there were material, there was prophecy that God was going to do exactly what he did with his son. It wasn't knee-jerk reaction. God's eternal plan has always been to send...
Who did he come for? Who did Jesus come for?
Who did he come for? First of all, he came for the Israelites.
He came for the Israelites.
First,
the Jews.
Yeah, the Jews. The Israelites. The Hebrews. The Jews. Yeah. First.
But then he changed his mind.
No. He didn't change his mind. That's what I'm saying. It was always in God's plan to come for the whole world. He came for a group of people on earth first, and then the rest after.
How's that? Say come twice?
God has no.
His message is limited.
Hold on, my friend. Let me answer properly.
Jesus' message is limited. He only come for certain.
No, my friend. I said quite clearly that Jesus came for the Jew first and then, because God had an order. So by me saying...
But clearly it's written in the Bible, it's only come for certain people.
No, once again, how do you come to the conclusion that by me saying that Jesus came for one group of people and then another, him only coming for that?
So when did he come? He comes twice?
No, logical. No. He came once, and the order of who he came for. There's an order for who he came for. He came once, and the message was to a group of people first, one group of people first, and then another group of people next. But let me go back to what you said about God. Yeah, we'll do.
Because I think we're going to go for it.
Yeah, we are going to go for dinner. We'll call you. And if you see, we'll do. And if you see, let me try and keep hold of him as well. Oh, right, okay. Yeah, I'll call you. Yeah. So
actually, I'll be all right.
Okay, let me get this clear. It was always, and in short, and succinct, it was always in God's plan. There was no knee-jerk reference to send the son. The scriptures, what they call the Old Testament, believe that. God's son was always in plan to send his son to die for the sins of the world.
Is that written in the Bible?
Yes, and the Old Testament makes quite clear that blood sacrifices are needed. I used to do that at one point. So an animal.
It sounds very paganistic.
It's irrelevant. No, it doesn't. No.
I mean, I'm going to be honest. I mean, why would God need to sacrifice?
I answered that question already.
Another human being.
I answered
it. Who himself was God.
Hold on, my friend.
Who died.
My friend, you answered all the typical questions. But let me answer.
It just follows logic.
I know, because you know why? Because you're thinking in terms of the Quran. That's what I'm saying. That's the problem.
No, so that the Quran's not even in it. No. The Quran's not even in it for me.
Yeah. No, my friend. Trying to pretend you're speaking independent of the Quran. We could all try to do that.
I'm not, because I don't really have much knowledge of the Quran either.
I know, but you have the general concept that God doesn't become a man. Let's not get ourselves.
I accept that. It's a very strange concept. It's a pagan.
It's not a pagan belief.
The Romans, who had many different gods, believed that.
The difference is those were myths. And that's why I
asked
you.
Why can't this be a myth as well?
This is why. Because did Jesus, because I asked you the question, did Jesus live on earth as an historical man? That's why I asked you the question. Because I genuinely don't believe what they think that. They just say that. But they really have Jesus as a historical, as a mythological figure. He's not really historical at all.
He's
not historical at all. You can see him.
I'm sorry, for anybody who knows the very basics of Islam, will clearly tell you that there is no Muslim on this earth that will tell you that we do not believe in Jesus Christ.
I know
we believe we do. So if you are telling us, you are actually standing here and telling us, the Muslims, that we don't believe in Jesus as a historical man who existed on this earth.
I'll tell you why.
How is that?
Because I said why.
But how?
Because I said, if you look at ancient...
There is no Muslim that will say that he physically was not present.
Right, it's one thing to say that, but then what follows after? So it's one thing to announce I believe this is historical, but then what follows after proves it?
We just don't believe he was the son of God, or God, or died on the cross, or God reincarnated.
Let me give you an example. Jesus was an Israelite, yes?
He followed the law, right. Didn't he?
Yes. And the Hebrews and the Jews did not call God Allah. That was not their name for God. There was a name.
I think that's very debatable.
No, it's not debatable.
The Jews call him Elohim. Yeah, which is a derivative of a Semitic-based language. Yes. Yeah. So the Arabs say Allah, and the Jews would say Elohim.
And those two words are not related. No. Don't try. That's a semantic. See, this is what they do, Michael. That's a semantic. Elohim has nothing to do with Allah. Elohim. It doesn't even sound the same. Elohim, which is the word of God, which is the word for God in the Old Testament. In the beginning, God created. The word being used is Elohim.
That's your view.
But what I'm saying is the word Allah has a history. At that time in the Old Testament, so, do you know the history of the word Allah?
Do you know? Can I just ask you a question if you don't mind? Yes, it's quite a pleasant conversation.
Yeah, sure.
Do you know there are millions of Arab Christians?
Absolutely, amen.
There are. And what do they call God?
Yeah, but we know why, because the Quran, they call God Allah.
What do you mean, why?
Yeah, hold on.
They don't say Jehovah.
What do they actually say?
Before you get excited,
do they say Jehovah?
The news is not as good as you look.
What is Arabic meaning father?
Sorry?
What do they call their father?
In Arabic.
No, I'm asking you a question again.
Yeah.
I'm agreeing with you firstly, so I want you to be honest with me. I'm being honest with you.
Yeah.
You asked me the question, what do the Arabs call
him? I said it's Allah.
They call him Allah.
They call him Allah.
Now, let's look at the...
I don't know if they call it father or...
What do they call their father? What do they call their father?
No, I'm saying this same God that they call Allah, it's my question. I'm asking a question. The same God that they call Allah, Arabic Christian, do they call him father?
What relevance is that?
I'll tell you in a while. I'll answer the question first.
I don't know. You should know. I only asked you the question out of interest.
Okay, you were saying
that Allah is not the name of God.
They do call
so
him.
I just thought, well, what do the Arab Christians call him?
They do call him Father. And if they call him Father, they're clearly not talking about Allah. You know why?
Who are they talking
because
about?
The Quran tells us Allah is the father to no one. Allah is the father.
But that's the Quran.
Allah has no children.
So these Arab Christians are liars.
Allah has no children.
So the Arab Christians are liars. Yeah?
No. The Quran is the problem.
No. But you said they call them Arabs.
It's a bit confusing.
There's nothing confusing. I'm saying there's a reason why the word Allah is in the Christian Bible. But when you look at it, the Arabs are under definition.
You believe the Father and the Son, the Holy Ghost.
That's political. Just because the Arabic.
No, hold on.
Can I answer?
Let me actually answer. Force them to say that.
Let me actually answer because this is important. I know you don't want to go here.
Okay.
Because what I'm saying is, it's like me calling. It's like, what example can I use? It's like me saying I respect you. This is a good example. It's like me saying I respect you, but then how the content of what I do and how I interact with you contradicts that.
You're wrong.
Doesn't it? So, these Christian Muslims, so I say I respect you, I like you.
These Christian Muslims?
I never got no time for you, I don't talk to you, I walk past you. It doesn't fit what I said, does it? I'm not interested in what people say. I'm interested in what they do. People say stuff all the time. As my mum puts it, people just say stuff because they've got a tongue. I'm not interested in what people say. I'm interested in what they do. If I say I respect you, if I show in everything I do. So I'm using that as an example. So these Christian Muslims, these Arab Christians call Allah God, but what is the nature of this God?
They call God Allah.
But the same God they call Father, when they create him, they call him Father. They believe that he has a son. This is the God they call Allah. Ask them, they're somewhere now. The God that they call
earlier we were discussing, they said they don't call Jehovah.
My friend, they call it Allah. There are Arab Christians here right now. There's one over there. What's the point?
I'm not confused.
The point is,
I feel like you're just really confusing.
No, you're confusing the issue because my son.
Arab. But you said Allah is not the name of God.
No, no,
so why
do
these Arab Christians call him Allah?
I just
that
said,
is a simple
because the
simple
Quran
question,
is translated in Arabic and it's political.
What's the politics? What, someone's going to shoot them if they don't call him Allah?
So how do you think...
Why don't you call him by his real name?
My friend, you're playing games. You are. You're playing games.
I don't understand where you're coming from. Well, your logic doesn't make sense.
Where I'm coming from is actually... This is not where I'm coming from. But again, I don't want to change the subject. I want to ask you about Surah 4157, which determines your and I destiny. That's really what I want to talk about.
But that's because you're going to be
You know the blood.
I'm
talking about what's more important.
We were talking about the blood of the thing and those adding to the...
Yes.
We were talking about that.
So should we go back to that?
But you went on and you changed it.
But a lot of questions have come.
Should we go back to that?
I changed because you actually
said... You don't want to change it, my friend.
No, I'm not changing because you are saying some stuff that doesn't make sense.
No, but
I'm only asking you the question.
But every time you do it, taking the subject away, you've got to realize that.
Well, I mean,
taking the subject away all the time.
But we need to clarify things.
Well, why can't we just say...
On the one hand, you are the one that say, you are the one that's saying Allah is not the name of God. Or God is not Allah. So I then said, hold on a second, what came to my mind was not something to try and put you down, but I was thinking, then what do the Arab Christians call God?
No, and your question is fine.
And then you clearly said they call him Allah, so then you're contradicting yourself.
Your question is fine, but can't you see that it's taking the subject away every time you ask questions,
but,
even though they're legitimate?
But then what you are saying,
what you are saying
almost contradicts yourself.
No, you're trying to get that to happen by asking me questions that was straight to
I'm not, you're self-contradicting.
Go back to the
you just said they don't call it Allah.
Right, thank you. The subject is Surah 4157. The Quran claims that Jesus didn't die. This is key.
But that's not the only thing that we differ with you about.
No, hold on. See, again. Again, let's stick on the subject. The subject is did Jesus die or did he not die?
No, you said did Jesus die or did he not die?
Let's verify.
The Quran said he did.
Let's verify.
Yeah, but that's one thing. But
now let's look at the details of why the Quran. Now the Quran, in Surah 41, the Quran says it's a detailed book. He said that this book is one of detail. Now there is no.
Well, you don't believe the Quran. Why are you quoting the Quran?
Right, this is the same way you quote the Bible.
We are discussing the Bible here.
Okay. Yeah.
Now you change the topic.
No. You decide. We're discussing both. The two claims that they make. One claim, already simple, my friend. Stop trying to make it complicated.
Okay.
My question is, did Jesus die or did he not?
In the Quran,
the two books are saying two different things. Right. The Quran said that he didn't. Right. I want to verify it. Can I verify by asking something?
You have to ask someone who really knows.
It's not enough to just... But you believe it. And I'm saying your turn is based on it. You believe it, but yet you're saying you're not knowledgeable in it. So then why do you believe it without going into further research?
Why do you believe Jesus died for your sin?
Do you believe your mother is your mother?
Yes, I can prove it as well.
Yeah, but did you prove it?
I can prove it, yeah.
Did you do the DNA test?
But did you prove it?
Yes.
Did you do the DNA test?
Yeah.
Oh, you did do it?
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Yeah. Well, I mean,
but even if many people don't. Okay, but even if they did.
So it doesn't mean to say that it's not true that your mother is your mother. It doesn't make it not true.
But you're not
just because. Okay. Because, no, but you asked me the question.
But you're not comparing
it like that. You ask me a question and you jump to another one. And I'm just clarifying.
Okay, fair enough. You're not comparing like with like.
I am comparing like with like because you said to me, why am I following something I have not proved?
But this is about.
I've listened to the argument.
Right. But even if my mum was my mum, that wouldn't affect my eternity. This is what I'm saying.
Well, it would.
No, it wouldn't.
No, I mean, what? No, it wouldn't.
That's
what
your belief. You believe it's eternity.
No, but you made a point to me. You made a point to me, and I asked you, and I was clarifying that point to you.
Okay,
because I'm not jumping from here to here. When you ask me a question, and then you jump to something else, then you're actually trying to make me look stupid.
For me?
Well, you did it because you said, why are you following something? You asked me a question, did you not?
Yes, I did.
You asked me a question.
Is that making you look stupid? It's a legitimate question. Why are you following something you don't believe in? Or you can't verify? That's a legitimate. How is that trying to make you look stupid?
As human beings, I've heard various arguments.
Yeah.
And the arguments to me that stand stronger is the fact that Jesus is not the Son of God. The argument to me, I've heard various arguments. Maybe you haven't heard those various arguments, but I have. And to me, it sounds more rational to accept that Jesus was not the Son of God or is God than the Islamic perspective where he says that he is just a prophet. So to me, that sounds more believable.
Okay, can I respond?
Yeah, of course.
Because Russian got nothing to do with it.
Well, it has, because God gave us a faculty to be able to reason. He didn't just dump us there and say, just, you know, believe everything.
Okay, so let me give an example.
How do you know what the devil tells you?
So is it rational that they get you to understand that God is eternal, you have no beginning, no end? Do you understand that by your rationale?
Yeah, I do.
Your rationale tells you that it makes sense of God is had no beginning, no end. I like your rationale.
It's rational for me to believe that there's a creator.
Right, no, but
it's rational
right.
for me to believe there's a creator. Reason, right. And it's a reason for me to accept that there is a creator. And it is a rational. I have listened to the rational. I have heard. Can I finish? I have heard the rational argument that there is a creator, okay, who is ever eternal, as opposed to somebody saying, well, no, there is no creator, and we just come about by chance.
Okay, so let me ask you something. Can you prove what it is? I don't want you to prove that God is there. But do you believe it? You can't prove it. Unless you can.
Well, I think my explanation may not be so clear, I think it can be proved.
Can you prove it?
I can prove it.
That God exists.
If I'm prove here, it. Then God is here.
No, that's not proof.
That's a proof.
That's a claim.
Because nothing came out of nothing.
That's a claim. That is another claim.
That's a claim.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but some people are saying something comes out of nothing.
Everything that surrounds us, yeah. Right?
So that's not rational.
That sounds even more irrational. Because reason dictates, logic dictates, that everything you see, no matter what you see around you, you could turn around and you could say that had a beginning and is very likely going to have an end. And from that,
you can deduce that
something does not come from nothing.
Absolutely, but
you can deduce that.
Absolutely, but it still doesn't ultimately prove that God created you.
Sorry?
It still doesn't ultimately prove that.
No, but you could ultimately then say there must have been a first cause.
Yes.
But not God. What you're really trying, well, I mean, you can call it God, you can call it teddy bear, you can call it whatever you want. But you can call it whatever you like.
Yeah, right.
But the argument leads to, that argument leads to, the other arguments may lead to another conclusion. But for me, the stronger argument is that there was a first cause.
Right. But it doesn't mean it was God as you understand it.
Well, no,
once you come to the conclusion that it's a first cause, it doesn't mean that the first cause is Allah, who you want to call it. It doesn't ultimately mean that.
There is nothing past that first cause.
What I'm saying, it doesn't mean that it was Allah who you call God that was the first cause.
What would it be then?
It's just proven now that there's a first cause, but it doesn't mean it's Allah.
You can call it whatever you like, but I call it Allah. And the Muslims call that first cause Allah.
Okay, but can we get back to the point about eternity? Because what I'm simply saying is,
all right,
yeah. Because I want
to
say,
so we just basically prove that there's a first cause, which we call God, which is Allah.
No. We haven't proved that at all. But let's carry on.
Are you disproving it?
We haven't proved that. Only proved that there's a first cause. Not that he's Allah. That's what I'm getting at. Doesn't mean he's Allah.
We'll call it whatever you like.
It could be Jesus.
But we call it Allah.
Who you would disagree with?
The Quran is a proof.
Let's get back to the point. Because I'm saying our eternity hangs on it. So why did your Quran say that Jesus didn't die without providing any proof? Doesn't the Quran support the proof? If a book is detailed, it should give me the details of the claim that Jesus didn't die and he was taken up and someone else was put in his place. Where are the details?
You really have to ask an Islamic scholar that
just
question.
Claim.
In another verse, it says that.
But then, that I can do that, but you believe it. So I'm asking.
But the Quran makes that claim, my friend.
I believe everything the Quran says.
Yeah. Why, though?
Because I have not heard an argument which is strong enough which has strongly countered the thing is, I don't need to.
I can give you one now.
I go to people of knowledge that really understand the Quran, that have studied it more than probably you and I. Okay,
but they're
and when
lying
I put those arguments, well,
they're
I mean,
lying.
They may lie. They may lie. But I have been given my own mind to be able to reason.
Okay.
So therefore, the arguments that they have put forward to me have always been logical, and I have been able to accept them. But nobody has somebody like yourself now. You can come along and you can say to me, Jesus is the eternal and he is the God. But your argument that you are putting forward to me, I'm not trying to just stand here as a Muslim and say, no. I'm saying you prove that argument to me and I'll be willing to accept your argument.
Okay.
But I just never ever heard from any Christian who has had an argument which has really countered the argument from a Muslim perspective, that Jesus is actually not the Son of God or is God. Every time I speak to a Christian regarding this kind of argument, it always seems to be a very emotional argument.
No, that's not the bit I'm talking about Jesus being the Son of God. I'm talking about Jesus dying. There's a difference. I'm not trying to argue about Jesus
I've even heard that argument.
I'm talking about
myself, I've heard that
I'm talking about the historical claim that the historical Jesus who you said you believed in, that lived and walked on earth, died. That's what I'm trying to establish. And history establishes that. Not that this person was the Son of God or God in flesh. That's not what I'm establishing. I'm establishing that this person who we're both agreeing was very human, died a human death.
It's very difficult to really... Look,
no,
my
it's
friend,
historical.
It's very difficult for me to really argue with your point. And the reason, and there's
because,
a reason behind
because
that.
Because the Quran doesn't use history, that's
no,
why.
No,
the
no,
Quran
no. You see, it's not about bashing the Quran. It's about trying to understand.
No, I'm not bashing
it.
I'm questioning because I can put forward
people like, for example, Brother Hashim or Brother Mansour, if you know who they are, right? And they're quite well known here. And if they was to argue with you regarding that, I've heard their arguments. I've been coming here for years myself.
What they've not given me is historical proof.
Have you learned anything from them?
Have you learned anything?
Yes. Takia is very real in the park.
Thank God cannot be a man.
You know something? Listen. You know Prophet Muhammad, right? Prophet Muhammad always said to be truthful.
Yeah.
So are you saying that he's lying now? He actually said for the Muslims to actually participate in taqiyya.
So are you saying that taqiyya is not practiced by Muslims right here in this park every week?
I'm not aware of it.
I'll give you an example.
I'm not aware of it. You seem to know a lot more than I do.
Yeah, no, they do all the time. You will bring something.
So an example is?
You will bring something to a Muslim from the hadith that is blatantly sahih. You know sahih means?
Yeah.
Yeah, right. So you can, beforehand, you can go to a Muslim and say, what does sahih mean? And they'll tell you. And then when you bring something that sahih, if it embarrasses them, they'll reject it.
Give me an example.
Like Muhammad's hygiene practices.
Such as?
Muhammad's hygiene practices. Yeah, yeah, about, you know, but I'm just giving you some examples. We're not going to go into them. Muhammad's hygiene practices about
you need water, to clarify
about water. Nothing can pollute water.
It's happening right now.
Or distort it. So there's a passage in the hadith where Muhammad encourages people to wash from water.
Well, look, I mean, I have differences of opinion, maybe amongst even my Muslim brothers.
I didn't want to
but
go into it.
When
that.
You go into talking about hadith,
hadith
is not Quran. Hadith, I don't hold it on the same level as
Quran.
But some
Muslims do. Are you Sunni Muslim?
No, I'm a Muslim that follows the Quran and the Sunnah.
Are you a Quran only Muslim then?
No, I'm not a Quran only.
So then you know that the hadith had the Al-Bukhari, you know, certain hadiths, are authentic. What they call, there are certain hadiths you know are authentic.
But these are these things that you come with are really very high scholarly debates. And for someone, an average layman like yourself,
no, I'm talking about.
Do you speak Arabic?
No, I don't.
Right, okay.
No, I don't. But do you speak Hebrew?
Sorry?
Did you read Quran?
Yes, very well.
Why do you say Quran is a lie in the Quran?
I didn't say Quran is a lie. I'm asking a question.
You say Jesus is not the Nero.
No, I'm asking a question. I didn't start off with a lie. I started off with a question.
You did. I hate
still not being answered. My question is, why did the Quran say that the Jews said they killed their Messiah? It doesn't make sense.
Because they did they not?
When did they Jews that were looking forward to a Messiah? I'm talking about the Jews that were looking forward to a Messiah. These are the very same ones that said they killed him. So, yeah, I don't know. It might be saying, you know, Michael's going to come and give me some money. I'm looking forward to Michael. He's a good mate of mine. He helps me out in life. And when he comes, I kill him.
I need to get to the bottom of what you're saying.
Right.
Let's get to it.
So, right. The bottom of what I'm saying is not just denying the crucifixion of Jesus. It's who it's putting the denial on that's the problem.
That light's well bright. Is that unfair specific reason?
I think that's filming or something.
No, brother.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I think I'm filming.
I think you're blocking it away.
Yeah. Well, good.
Am I going to be a star on YouTube?
Yeah. So let's get to the crux of what I'm saying. Let's get to the crux of... Do you know Ahmedidad?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, Ahmedidad shamelessly said, regarding Surah 4157, he said, regarding this Surah, we Muslims, he's speaking for all of you, and he's your scholar, so you kind of come under him, we Muslims for Surah 4157, ask no questions and seek no proof. Imagine that.
What's that?
For the claim that Jesus didn't die and that someone had a replacement.
That doesn't sound like a very. That doesn't sound like a
Medina. Oh, no, I know like that. He said that in his book. He's talking about. Have you read his book? You must read it. His book called Crucifixion or Crucifixion.
No, but it's
blatantly. He once again did himself because, you know, they wouldn't take so what I'm saying is,
I think you're sincere. I think there's a little bit of this.
I'm asking.
I think there's a little bit of takia on your part.
Explain. Where's the takia? One second. Sorry,
because I think you come here with the premise of just trying to put the Muslim down.
It just seems. First of all, my friend, this is Speaker's Corner. This is what we're here for, if we choose to discuss stuff. Why is it when somebody asks Muslims a question, they consider it an attack? This I don't understand.
Really. No.
Have I attacked you at any point? I've been constantly trying to re-ask my question.
You're saying you made the assertion that Muslims are we practice takia.
Yeah, Muslims do practice takia. Well, and if you don't, then fine for you. But Muslims practice takia here. I've just proved it to you.
I've proved it to you that
if I bring something that's sahih, depending on what it is, do you know what takia is, by the way?
It means you can lie and do cheat or deceive them.
But it's more than that. You can lie for the cause of Allah if it's going to bring glory to Him. That's
what
it is. If it's going to bring glory to Allah or if it's going to help the faith.
I'm born a Muslim.
Right.
All right. And I'm being honest with you. I'm 47 now.
Okay.
And nobody has ever taught me that Prophet Muhammad wanted this to be something which is we must do this as Muslims. I don't know about it.
Okay, why not?
Why not? Mm. Because it's never ever been mentioned to me. It's not something that is practiced for the Muslims that I know. And I know some Muslims that are quite highly educated and quite scholarly. I never said, guess what? When you come across a Christian, lie to him. I never come across that.
So let me ask you a question. So are you
Muslim? Yeah. So have you, you know, this brother
so
here.
Do you know what takia means?
He's saying we must practice takia.
Do you know what takia means? Do you know what takia means?
We must lie and deceive.
So you've not even heard the word takia?
Yeah. But that's what I'm trying to say, look. No. And you're saying people are practicing takia. It's not
all the time.
It's not a common trend.
And I'm giving you. No, it's here. I'm talking about here. I just gave you an example of when something's given, if it's like Muhammad marrying an underage girl. You know, they try and judge.
This is a very controversial.
No, wait a minute. No, it's not. The hadith said that Aisha.
Hadith can say what it wants.
No, sahih. No, my friend. See, this is what I mean. Look, you're bordering on yourself. Be careful.
What takia?
Because for you to dismiss what sahih. Well, is what leads to takia.
No, it doesn't.
It does, my friend. No. If something is sahih, that means it's authentic.
No,
and if I present it to you and you say that doesn't matter.
Shall I tell you something? Look,
my friend.
Look, I'm not disputing any hadith, okay, because I'm not in a position to do that. However, if you was to get two very high knowledgeable hadith scholars, okay, at their level, they may disagree.
No, that's not what I'm talking about.
What, they don't?
Let me give an
Can
example.
Can I just ask you the question? Do you
know
No,
let
agree?
Me give an example.
Do they disagree?
No, don't change the subject.
Do high-level
Islamic
hadith
subject.
Scholars...
Let me give an example of what I mean.
Did you hear, actually hear what Aiden said?
Yes, I did. But you're going off the subject. I want to stay on the subject. If I give you something that's sahih, al-Bukhari,
right.
Is sahih, yes?
Right.
Al-Bukhari is sahih. Can we agree?
Okay.
No, can we agree?
Yeah.
It's no, I want him to agree.
It's considered to be sahih.
Well, no, yeah, it's not considered. It is. Right. But do you agree that it is?
It's not written in stone.
It's not
sahih.
No,
we don't
know. No, it is written in stone, my friend. What does sahih mean? Do you know what it means?
Well, I know, yeah.
What does the word mean?
It means verified.
Yes.
Authentic.
Authentic.
Yes. But so if it's authentic, that means it's trustworthy. That means what it says is.
Do you know, my friend?
Yes. It's something.
Do you know from the week?
My friend, how does that make sense? If it's authentic and it's trustworthy, it's true.
Can I just say to you, just for your understanding as a Christian, even if there is a sahih hadith,
yeah.
Okay, scholars of hadith who understand the sciences of hadith,
yeah.
They themselves at certain levels disagree.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What do they disagree about?
They disagree on the actual
Quran
hadith and the
true.
Meaning
that's
and the understanding. But they don't dispute. Like, no, they never, ever, I have never come across an Islamic scholar that will turn around and say to you that the words of the Quran we disagree on.
No, that's
but
not true,
they disagree
actually.
On hadith.
No, they don't.
Whether it's sahih
or
not sahih, they disagree.
No, they don't. No, they don't.
Islamic scholars do.
Give me two scholars that do.
Sorry?
Give me two scholars that do. I don't know.